In this video, I want to show and explain to you the 12 volt LED ceiling light system that I recently installed into the shed that I've just finished building. Here is a high level network schematic of the circuit in my shed. So let's start. The shed has a floor area of 6.5 meters by 3.5 meters. We'll start with the light switch on the right hand side. So the entrance to the shed is just a door here. You come in the door, you can turn on the switch 1 or switch 2. The switch is powered by a circuit, positive circuit, that runs to a 12 volt 240 mAh lithium iron phosphate battery. The cable that I've used is 5mm auto cable, which has a 2.9 millimeter square cross-sectional area. Similarly, the negative return cable is also a 5mm auto cable, 2.9 millimeter square cross section. So if we go back to the positive circuit, when I close the circuit, if I close switch 1, it provides current to these two sets of LED lights. This is a 3 meter tri-per SMD5630 LED, 10 mil wide. It comes supplied in a 5 meter roll, and the power consumption is 14 watts per meter, and the luminance is 1440 lumens per meter. It only costs $17 to buy on eBay from a store, DIY Life AU2014, which I believe is the online store for Triper Australia, located in Dandenong, Victoria. I cut the strips so that one length is 3 meters and the other length is 2 meters. If we go back to switch box, switch number 2, when you close the circuit, it will provide power to these two sets of LED lights, also 3 meter and 2 meter long. But they, I bought these from a different company, Eltronics in Melbourne. The product is X3215A alpha. It's a 12 volt 5 meter, uses SMD5050 LED chipset. It's also 10 mil wide. Power consumption 14 watts a meter, and the luminance is 720 to 840 lumens per meter. But you know what? After I've installed it and using Mark II eyeballs, I actually think this one's a brighter than that, even though the stated luminance is supposedly brighter on the tripod. Oh, by the way, they're both IP65 rated. Doesn't cost much more to have it IP65 rated. The return circuit just goes along a common bus back to the negative terminal of the 12 volt battery. Next, I will go to the shed and show you the actual installation. So let's start with the LED light switch box. I purchased a 4-gang switch only because it was easier just to find a 4-gang switch, but really I only use these two. So there's only a positive 12 volt cable that goes along here, and this is the first row of LED ceiling lights. And as you can see, I've just joined them with a very simple end cap connectors. Then from here on, the conduit contains both positive and negative. Runs to the next row of ceiling lights. In this case, because this particular LED light strip product came with a 2.1mm DC plug, I had to use this bare wire to 2.51mm socket to connect it. And here I've just joined two sets of negative return cables to a, so that I make it a return bus. And then from here it goes back to ceiling light row number 2. Same thing, join up the positives and the negative returns. So now you see there's three sets of negative returns. This is just a 240 volt AC extension cord that powers off my inverter. And if you look at this, that's the fourth and last LED ceiling strip light, and that's how it's joined. So you follow the black split loom, comes down. The second black split loom contains my photovoltaic 6mm square power cable from the solar panel. The cable extends behind this whiteboard. So to continue the 12 volt ceiling light cable, that's it. So now this contains both a positive and negative cable. This one is my 12 volt photovoltaic power cable to the solar panel. Oh, this massive one is my Anderson SB350 plug to between my inverter and the battery. And this is my Enerdrive Adventurer solar charging AC-DC charging system, DC-DC charging system, and inverter. And we follow the cable trail that's from the ceiling lights, and it comes to the and this SB50 Anderson plug I have here, which is how I connect to the ceiling lights and to every other load device. This makes it very easy for me to remove this entire system so that I can move it, if I want to, say to a four-wheel drive utility truck. This is how I designed this system, and that's the CALB 12 volt 240 mAh battery with a daily 250 amp battery management system. I will be talking about this solar system in another video, so subscribe to my channel and you'll have a chance to follow it. Now if you are wondering how I secured the LED lighting strip, this was what I did. The wall is 12 millimeter plywood, so I screwed in a eyelet into the cladding. Then I used this tensioner, right, and tied to the end. Is I think it's 1.2 millimeter diameter tie wire, steel tie wire, which I then pull and stretch across to the opposite wall. And on the opposite wall, similarly, there is a steel eyelet screwed into the 12 mil plywood. So this is at the opposite wall. So there's that steel eyelet, and there's a tie wire stretching across the other side. Now this is a semi-concave 16 mil wide electrical conduit. So that wraps around the tie wire, and then using through adhesive tape, there's a 12 mil aluminium strip, flat aluminium strip, glued to the flat surface of this conduit. And lastly, the LED strip is taped to the aluminium strip. Now the benefit of this is that if the LED strips get hot, the aluminium strip is a heat sink for the LED strip. So that's how this is secured. Well, I hope you found the this particular video about my 12 volt ceiling light system install informative. And if you did, I hope you will put a like to this video. And if you subscribe, I will be doing a follow-up video on this Enerdrive Adventurer system, which includes a solar panel, AC-DC, DC-DC charging, and inverter, and explain my choices in coming up with this product, as well as the Tindo solar panel. See you next time.